How's it going, everybody? Wyatt back here again at the Team O'Neill Rally School. One of the more requested videos that we've had that we'd like to do for you right now, tire pressures. Tire pressures as they relate to high performance driving. This isn't about street tire pressures. You know, follow whatever it says in your owner's manual if you're just getting around and driving around town and that sort of thing. But if you're out there, you're ripping around and you're going hot and you're thinking about, hey, where do I really set these tire pressures to get the max out of them? Rally specific, you're in a rally car and this could pertain to, you know, hey, you're taking it out on a track, you're doing a rally cross, an autocross, whatever it is. What you're gonna find is, it depends how big your tires are and how much your car weighs. If you have big tires on a little small car, you're going to be able to go much lower than you would if you had, say, a big car on, you know, little tires for some reason. So this is an exaggeration, but hopefully it just gets the point across real quick so we can move on. Moral of the story is find an appropriate size tire for your vehicle, but know that this is a big variable. Two variables at play, the weight of your car, not the size of it, because these tires need to kind of stay up and hold up. The amount of air in these tires needs to hold this car up. So it's a volume of the air and the weight of the car. You can go much lower. You know, you see Jeeps out there rock crawling around at, you know, 10 PSI or less, depends on the size of the tire. And you see guys out there, you know, the lowrider dudes that have the little tiny tires on the spoke wheels and stuff, probably have a lot of air in them so they can get around without getting a flat tire everywhere they go. So that's what you're up against. But if you pick a tire size that's reasonable for your vehicle, we can move on. So let's just get that variable out of the way. That's what you're going to be dealing with. So tire pressures. Let's say you've got 10 psi, 20, 30, 40, 50 psi of compressed air. And let's stick with compressed air for right now. We'll talk about nitrogen in a second. What you're going to see is that as you're driving around, you know, at very low pressures, let's make this green be tire performance. This is my performance marker. Your tire pressure, your tire performance is going to be very low at very low temperatures, and it's going to increase quickly, right? You have a nearly flat tire, you have to drive very slowly, it's going to blow up, it's going to be a bad day, but that's going to get much better as you add air to it. And at some point, there's going to be the magical amount of air where it works the best. And then what's going to happen is it's going to drop off dramatically from there. This is just a guesstimation. We'll talk about the real numbers in a second, but that's about what you're going to find your tire performance does. In a rally car, what we're talking about is how well your car stops, how well it accelerates, how quick you can go around corners and stay stuck to the road and that sort of thing. There's a happy place and it's right up here, and that's where you want to be. Your tire reliability, your red reliability marker, as you have no air in the tire, it's going to be terribly unreliable. You wouldn't even want to drive. But as you add air to it, you're going to find it gets better and better and better. And then at some point, the tire is very, very reliable and it sort of stays flat. Unless you hyper overinflate it and then you have a catastrophic failure. But nobody's really going to be there. Be careful with rally tires because sometimes it takes a lot of air to mount them on the wheel. And if you leave that, you know, 80 PSI in there and go drive, just don't do it, check your tires, it's not that hard. So this is what you're dealing with as far as performance and reliability is something similar to this. You don't ever wanna be over here. No benefit to being over there. Why would you? And maybe that's at 32. Maybe that's your line where you know, because you go out and do just a little bit of practice, there's no reason to be above 32 PSI because there's no additional reliability and all you're doing is losing performance. So that's where you would know, and that's a pretty realistic number, somewhere around 32. Why would you go there? There's no point. You also need to figure out through a little bit of testing and that kind of thing where, you know, you don't want to go down below, say 20 for this example. You know, could be very different depending on, like I said, the weight of your car, the size of your tires, and that kind of thing. But you need to know that this is also a no-fly zone, right? So there's no reason to go anywhere within that realm. How do you dial this in? What you're looking for is this magic spot, right? So 32, this might be
your safe running pressure. You might know I've got maximum reliability. I don't have quite as much grip as might be available to me if I went a little lower, but if you're rallying right around there, 30, 32 pounds in your tire, you're never gonna get a flat, you're gonna get pretty good grip, and everything's gonna work out pretty well for you. But that's boring. Let's talk about, you know, hey, if somebody's beating you, if you wanna go a little faster, know that as you drop your tire pressures, your grip available is gonna go up to a certain degree, but your reliability is gonna go down. So this, you know, if you're here and you're floating around, you know, the high 20s, say this is 27 PSI, is where you know, hey, I've got a little better grip, but my tires are a little bit softer. They're gonna be more prone to getting a flat tire maybe, or punching them off of the wheel or something like that. And you might know that, hey, 25 is my magic number. It's not my magic number, it's not anybody's magic number, this is a theoretical number, but it's pretty close probably, depends on your car, to saying 25 is my magic number, where I know I've got the most available grip, but I also know that the tire is a little bit fragile. It's a little bit extra soft. I'm really gripping the road, they heat up, I've got a lot of heat in the tires, they're sticking to the road really well, I've got a nice footprint on the ground. Everybody knows why this works, right? You've got a lot of air in your tire. It's like driving like this down the road. You've got a very small contact patch. As you lower the tire pressure, you know, you've got more contact with the ground and a bigger footprint, and you've got more grip by doing that. So that's why this is working. But when your tires are bulging like that, the sidewalls are more prone to sharp rocks. If you're hitting rocks sideways, or if you bump into a bank, you're gonna knock that tire right off the wheel. But that's where you know, okay, 25 is my magic number, and so maybe, you know, hey, you're, hey, let's never go below number is 23. You know, maybe that's your hard line of don't ever wanna go there either. So you can do a little bit of testing and figure this out for yourself. If you just have, you know, take your car to a rallycross or take somewhere safe, bring it here and just go do a couple laps around. Give us a call and let us know, hey, I wanna do some tire testing with different kinds of tires, different kinds of grip and that sort of thing, because you need to know, this is my old faithful reliable number. You know, this is my, hey, I wanna really kind of go for it number. This is my, I'm gonna go racing, you know, we're going for it number, and anything below that is just not safe. But if all of a sudden you put smaller tires on your car, or bigger tires on your car, or it's really hot out, or it's really cold out, this is all gonna fluctuate a little bit. If you're running normal compressed air in your tires, as your tire heats up, the air molecules expand and your pressure increases. So you haven't added air to the tire, but say it's 50 degrees out and you go racing and your tire gets up to 100 degrees or something like that, you're gonna notice a change in that tire pressure, where if it's at 32 cold, you might be, I'll use the red just to make it clear, if this is 32 cold, you might be at 35 hot, you know, once those tires warm up just by driving them. And that can change more or less than that. A small tire is not going to change very much. A bigger tire is going to change much more with the temperature. So if you're, you know, going out to do Baja and you've got some big old, you know, Baja TAs on a pre-runner or something, that's going to change tire pressure a lot, where a rally tire isn't so much, or certainly a smaller tire isn't so much still. Nitrogen is a great solution. Most of the top guys or run a nitrogen. You can order, I think if you get tires from Tire Rack, you can say, hey, put nitrogen in them instead of normal air, because it doesn't fluctuate that much. You know, so if it's summer or winter, or the tire's hot because you're out on the track, or it's cold because you're in the paddock or something like that, you've got about the same. It's still gonna change, still, you know, definitely look into that and see how much it works and where your happy places are. For rally, specifically, we don't get too insane. What we'll do is, you know, front versus rear, just really quickly, if you had a car that's a really ugly boxy car. That's the front of the car, in case you were curious. If the car's not turning, if you got a lot of understeer, if it's just pushing wide in the corners and that sort of thing, you want to go lower with the front pressure and higher with the back to increase the grip that's available in the front and or make the back end a little bit looser. If it's too loose and it's sliding all over the place and the back end's just out of control, you would want to go down with the back to get a little more grip, or up with the front, or a little bit of both. So you can play those games. You know, if you're circle track racing side to side and certainly corners, you know, in a rally car, we don't get much more complicated than, you know, changing, drop the fronts a little if it's pushing, you know, or drop the rears a little if it's too tail happy, or, you know, basically think I've covered that. So hopefully that makes sense. So that's the nutshell with tire pressures. If you're doing different things, maybe you're not rallying, this all still exists. It's just these numbers change. So whatever it might be, you could be racing a spec Miata or going out and doing track days, or you know, you might be off-roading. So you've got a Jeep and you're out in Moab driving around on rocks. You need your maximum available tire pressure. You need to know what's, you know, what's really safe, what's good, what's, you know, superstar good, and then what's maybe not so good, or whatever it might be. But, you know, if you're in Moab with a Jeep and you're driving around on slippery rocks, you know, this might be 5 PSI, and this might be 20 PSI. And these magic numbers might be around 10, depends wheel and tire size, weight of the vehicle. If you're in a UTV or a side-by-side or motocross or anything else, it's the same. It's just change these numbers at the bottom to whatever's relevant for you and your situation and go from there. But these are just nice things to know, to have in the back of your head, so that when you're racing, you need a little more performance, you know where to go safely, you know where to take a chance if you need to, and you know, hopefully that gets you out there, gets you doing a little better in races, gets you finishing races, and getting you the results that you want. So, I've been Wyatt, this has been the Team O'Neill Rally School. Check out the website, give us a shout anytime. If we can help with anything, throw it in the comments section. If you like this kind of videos, you know, throw in some ideas at the bottom, and we can always do some more videos for you guys. We're happy to share it, and yeah, happy to help out any way we can. So, thanks for watching, have a good one.